Listen to that. Does that sound like a truck to you? Or does it sound like a car? Because I've been having an argument all day driving and reviewing this 2017 Honda Ridgeline, because I know there's a bed in the back. I know it's all-wheel drive. I know it looks like a truck, but when I'm driving it, gosh, I think it's either a crossover or a car. And well, I'll let you decide, because coming up right now is our first drive review of this brand new Honda Ridgeline. My first time behind the wheel, and with me today is Honda, well, let's call him super fanboy, Honda Pro Jason.
Stop yourself, Roman.
Now, we just sat through the product presentation.
Yes.
And Jason, I gotta tell you, the PR guy actually kept calling this a car.
Maybe once, maybe twice. But we talked about that last night.
And as I get behind the wheel, it probably is more of a car or crossover than a pickup truck.
Because it's comfortable to drive?
Yes, it's very comfortable to drive.
And the seat position's good?
The seat position's good. I love this. Check this out. It ratchets, man.
It's amazing. A lot of Hondas have the ratcheting, but only on the driver's side.
Yeah.
This has it on driver and passenger, which I think is awesome.
Yeah, no, it's also very expensive. It starts at just $30,000
for
the two-wheel drive. And every
front
time
wheel
I
drive.
Say, yes, two-wheel drive, think front-wheel drive, to over 40, I think it's almost $3,000 for the top-of-the-line Black
Correct.
Edition, right?
The Black Edition with all the extra toys and bed truck audio.
Everybody wants music at your party. So what we did is we did some brainstorming. We tried to come up with some different ideas. And what we ended up coming up with was this. So this is an audio exciter. It's an existing technology that's used in home audio systems and things like that. But this is the first application that anyone's using in a truck bed. And so what this is it basically functions like a speaker, but it's not a speaker. So a speaker is a magnet on one side of the speaker and a cone on the other. So the magnet creates the vibration when it gets its signal from its audio unit, and then the cone moves back and forth, pushes air, makes sound. So what this audio exciter does is it works like the magnet. It creates the vibration that becomes the sound. But our cone is the entire panel on the side lining of the bed, or on the headboard of the bed. So basically what we do then is we vibrate the entire panel. So we do that, we've got two exciters mounted to each side lining of the bed, and they vibrate the panel just like a speaker. The big advantage though is a speaker is fairly small and it needs a lot of travel to make the sound. Since this is such a large panel, it needs just a small amount of vibration to make that same amount of sound. So it uses a lot less power than a normal speaker would. Also, these are sealed, they're waterproof, so that there's no concern having them in the truck bed that they would be, you know, have corrosion happen or any damage to the electronics because they get wet like a normal speaker would. And we've made sure that since they're mounted to the bedside and you're gonna use your truck bed like a truck bed and put objects in it and carry things, that anything that might slide around or any cargo that you might be throwing up into the bed doesn't damage the parts, so that you don't have any concern about not being able to play your music once you get to your tailgate.
Now, Jason and I have been having, well, let's not call it an argument, let's call it a discussion about the fact that this is somewhat of a crossover, maybe even a car.
It's a pickup truck.
All right, Jason. So what configuration in terms of drive can you get it in?
You can get it in all-wheel drive, or you can get it in two-wheel drive, and the two-wheel drive is front-wheel drive.
What? Wait. Yep. Hold on. It's a front-wheel drive truck?
It is a front-wheel drive pickup truck.
Why is it a front-wheel drive pickup truck?
I mean, Honda's done some looking around, and they've realized that most of the people, especially in California, are looking for a two-wheel drive truck and a front-wheel drive truck.
All right. You know, it is the only front-wheel drive truck.
That's a good thing, though. It stands out. Top of its class.
In the presentation, they kept saying this was best in class in a lot of different ways.
Yeah.
And I will give it the not only best in class, but only in class truck bed audio. So there are speakers mysteriously hidden somewhere.
Exciters inside the edges in the back, and you can listen to music while you're tailgating.
That's cool.
I think it's cool. I mean, it's better than bringing a big boombox or your own speakers or trying to play it through your iPhone. It all works through Bluetooth.
Yeah, that's
so
cool.
So you can have your phone with you, and you can adjust it. You can actually do it from an iWatch, an Apple Watch.
Yeah.
You can adjust all your music from the Apple Watch anywhere around the car, which is pretty cool.
You can tailgate, and you just call it a car again, because it's a car. It really is a car.
You're gonna put a little dot up there every time, a little hashtag, aren't you? Ding, ding, ding. Yeah.
Because okay. Listen. It triple seals, all kinds of sound deadening. This is
acoustic feedback windshield.
It's the most quiet truck that I've ever driven.
You've driven a lot more trucks than I have.
I mean,
to be honest, I haven't. The only other truck I've driven is Ridgeline.
Yeah.
So when it comes to trucks and comparing them, I'm out of my element. So I'm going to rely on you more than that.
My name is Kerry McClure. I am the large project leader or chief engineer for this all new 2017 Honda Ridgeline.
Now, the last time there was a Ridgeline was 2014. So
That's correct.
2 years, right?
Since 2 years out of the market.
Yeah. And what have you learned in those 2 years? How is it better than the outgoing?
Well, we've actually started, you know, from when we launched the original Ridgeline back in 2006, our learning started at that moment. So we've been learning for the last 10 years. But we learned a lot about what customers loved about the Ridgeline and a few things about what they would like to improve with this new Ridgeline.
So what have you improved?
We've improved lots of things. Yeah. I think the most notable would be the exterior styling of this vehicle.
It's more truck-like.
It is more truck-like. We wanted to keep still this modern, unique front end of this vehicle. It's very aerodynamic.
Yep.
It's very modern and clean, but at the same time provide a more traditional truck profile. So as you walk around the side, you'll notice that the bed to cab cut or shape is similar to most of the other trucks in the market.
Yeah, you used to have one big piece of molding. Actually, it's not molding, it's stamping at the back, right?
That's right.
And it made it look like it was one big truck.
Right.
And now it looks more like a traditional truck.
It looks more traditional. It serves multiple purposes. We now have a bolt-on rear fender, so it's easier to repair if you needed to do that, but it also lends itself to this traditional profile that we were looking for.
Jason, I'm sure you know this. Check out this cut line right here. This wasn't in the old truck. In fact, this was the largest stamping that Honda ever did. Now, the new one has it. Is that because, like most mid-sized trucks, this is now a body-on-frame truck?
This truck is not a body-on-frame truck. It's actually a unibody truck.
All right. Why?
For a couple different reasons. One, it allows us to have more room inside.
Yeah.
But also, it's able to hide the multi-link rear independent suspension.
Wait. There's not a solid rear axle like most mid-sized trucks have?
There is not. And that's going to help during long hauls, long drives. You won't be as fatigued afterwards.
Is it going to help off-road?
It won't probably help off-road. That's where the torque vectoring comes in.
You and your torque vectoring.
I love it.
Enough of that. In this top-of-the-line truck, right?
Yeah.
You've got all these safety features that you would only see in maybe high-end cars, right? We're looking at
blind spot monitoring.
We're looking at, it's called adaptive, lane keep, right?
Adaptive cruise control, lane keep assist, it'll keep you in your lane. There's plenty of sensing, what Honda calls your sensing package in here, which, like you said, you usually see on higher-end cars.
Yeah, it's almost like it's got the features of a luxury car. There's a huge 8-inch touchscreen that comes with navigation. And here's the cool part, right? When you go to the navigation, look at that. We got a little trick there. How cool is that?
And I showed you earlier, you can change the color.
Yeah, because we have a silver truck, and of course, that's a red truck.
It's a red truck.
Yeah, but it's really cool.
Why did you decide to go front-wheel drive?
Well, two-wheel drive came directly from our dealers in the southern states, so
yep.
The Sun Belt, as we like to call it. They said that based on their experience with customers for our other light truck vehicles, they knew there was a market for a two-wheel drive Ridgeline to get a lower entry price for the customers. And why front-wheel drive? Well, why front-wheel drive for any other car? You know, if you look at a passenger car, that question doesn't come up anymore unless you're talking a true sports car, for example. So front-wheel drive is better in many, many conditions, and we feel that still applies for mid-size trucks as well.
All right, Jason, I see a traditional automatic. How many gears?
6 speeds.
All right, now a lot of trucks in this class come in a manual.
Not a manual option for Honda, but it does have torque vectoring.
Torque vectoring?
Torque vectoring.
What's torque vectoring?
That's going to send torque to the wheel that needs it. So in all different situations, you'll have torque, and it won't use braking. It'll actually use torque to get you around the turns.
All right, now it is all-wheel drive, but where is my transfer case?
Transfer case.
Yeah, transfer case. You know, high-low transfer case. The stuff that trucks have.
Did I mention it has 4 different drive modes?
No, man, show me.
Let me show you those 4 different drive modes. You have normal mode.
Yeah.
Snow mode, mud, and sand. And these are all individual modes that can either shut off the VSA or it can start the car in second gear if needed.
What's a VSA?
VSA is vehicle stability control.
All right.
Sometimes through mud or snow, you need to shut that off so you can get the traction that you need.
All right, and where's the tow haul mode?
tow haul.
Yeah, mode. Tow haul mode, the thing that trucks have, you know, that helps you tow and haul, tow haul mode.
Did I mention there's a 400 watt inverter in the back so you can plug things in?
No, but I guess that's good. Easy to use, except they completely lost the volume knob.
Okay, so they continued with the anti-volume knob, but even with a glove on, and we don't have gloves because it's like 100 degrees in Texas today, but we have a hat, yeah. And I can show you guys with a hat, with my finger in the hat, you can press on items and you can press on it and it'll change to what you want. So pretend this is a glove. So even in the winter, you can still press things and have them work. But yes, there is no volume knob, you're correct.
But that brings up a really good point. And the point is that Honda has really walked away from the, I think, independent contractor, the guy who is the, you know, plumber or the handyman who needs a truck, because A, it's very expensive, and B, it's very comfortable and luxurious, and C, it's not very truck-like. All right, so this is a powertrain that might be familiar to some people, right? Because it's basically the powertrain out of the Pilot.
That's very correct. It's a 3.5 liter DI VTEC VCM engine. Puts out 280 horsepower and 262 pound-foot of torque.
And what I noticed immediately when I floored it was you could tell when the VTEC kicks in. That's really cool.
Yeah, absolutely.
So here's how we do this nowadays, because obviously we'll do a full line of towing tests and off-road tests when we get up to Colorado, but you count 1,000 to 1,000.
Sure.
And I'll just hit the go button, give it the beans.
Hang on. I'll do one better for you.
Oh, no, just do
okay,
it.
Okay, let's do it.
Do it. This is not scientific in the least, all right?
Yep.
So 3, 2, 1.
1 1,000, 2 1,000, 3 1,000, 4 1,000, 5 1,000, 6 1,000, 7 1,000.
Boom. 8. So I'm going to say 7.5 seconds.
I'll say 7.5.
Yeah.
How's that rate? I mean, I think that's pretty good.
Yeah.
It felt good.
Yeah. Did you hear the VTEC kick in?
I did. I heard the VTEC kick in, which is pretty incredible.
Yeah, that was really cool. Let me see if I can show that to you guys. So you'll hear the engine at its normal rate, right?
Yep, and right around, sudden, I think it's right around 5,500 or so.
Yeah, it goes,
it'll open up and just start hauling.
Yeah, listen, it's really cool. Right there?
There it is.
There's the VTEC.
Yes.
That is so cool.
That is cool.
One more. And there's the VTEC. Yeah.
And you get a lot more performance out of this engine, both for fuel economy and for acceleration. We didn't have to compromise one for the other. So we got class-leading performance for fuel economy and class-leading acceleration at the same time.
Now let's talk about the all-wheel drive version. What are the fuel economy numbers?
We have 18.25 for the four-wheel drive version or all-wheel drive version, 19.26 for the two-wheel drive version.
And I believe that's best in class, right?
It is best in class, absolutely.
Yeah, so you guys rocked it when it comes to fuel economy.
That's right.
And it's, I think, what, 3 MPG better than the outgoing Ridgeline?
It's depending on which one you're comparing to, plus 3, plus 4, even plus 5 if you're comparing two-wheel drive to the previous.
Now, how come there's no turbo in here? I know turbos are big now. Why is there no turbo in there?
Maybe that's something that will come in the future. It's just not currently one. We don't have a V6 that with turbos that we would drop into this truck at this time.
Honda says that the Ridgeline has best-in-class passenger room and, of course, best-in-class rear seat room. That's a very thoughtful thing to do. Jason, come on in here. Show us what that actually means in real life.
So in real life, these seats move around a couple different ways, which is cool. It's a 60-40 split. So we'll pull over a lever, this will come right up, so you have a lot of room for taller items. And if you need even more room, this side lifts right up. You have more room. The only thing in this is this little piece of plastic here. Otherwise, you have a lot of room top to bottom.
Yeah, I mean, you could put a bike in here.
You can, with the front wheel on, you can put a bike in here. No other truck can do that. Also, this back window is power sliding back and forth.
All right.
Which is cool. Center console has a couple cup holders.
Yep.
And Honda's actually tested this rear area up to 30 miles an hour with a half a ton payload. So in case there's an accident from the rear, it won't come into the passenger compartment.
That seems very safe to me. I like it.
It's Honda safety.
Right. I don't see the guy who has his own plumbing business buying this necessarily to throw all his stuff in there. It's just too much of not a tool. And what I mean by that is a lot of people buy trucks because they're the biggest tool, the most competent tool in their toolbox, right? And this doesn't have a lot of those tool-like qualities, so towing is not best in class. No four-wheel drive.
But you just talked about a plumber or someone does some light-duty stuff.
Yeah.
5,000 pounds of towing would be perfect for him. And most people that own their own small businesses might not be able to afford a car and a truck. this one does both for them.
My name is Craig Fidausch. I am the strength and reliability project leader for the 2017 Honda Ridgeline. I've been working with Honda for over 20 years. Now this event is very severe. A metal bed will be damaged. However, we are not a metal bed. We are a material that is called SMC, sheet molded composite. You're gonna learn more about that in the bed exploration area. So what is this real world event that I'm talking about? Got the hint, right? Well, it's heading to the Vault Supply store, picking up a load of river rock at max payload. These rocks weigh anywhere from 7 to 22 pounds. So without further ado, I introduce to you the rock drop.
Modern trucks have a dampened tailgate, and that means that when you open it, it won't do that. It won't slam like that. Jason, why didn't Honda dampen their tailgate?
For one really good reason, because Honda's tailgate also does this. Dual action. How cool is that?
Now, does that help with torque vectoring?
It does not, but it does help with loading and unloading.
And it will appropriate power to whatever wheels it feels have the most traction.
True.
Yeah.
And what do we call that system?
We call that Honda's special, it's like TS, special, secret, all-wheel drive, TQV.
Torque vectoring, by the way. It's torque vectoring.
There's some long ass, you know, highly secretive, all-wheel drive, TQS. That's what we call it. I think that's what Honda calls it. This is one of the nicest interiors. There's no sense of cost cutting whatsoever. Is that what you were going for?
Absolutely. We wanted to make sure that we had the highest quality materials, fit and finish, and appearance, as well as the greatest amount of technology in this truck, and especially for this class. Our previous customers told us that they were really missing out on those things. And we have a lot of customers that are moving into the segment from SUVs or CUVs, and that's what they're used to. They're not used to a cheap interior. They really want the high quality stuff.
Yeah, I noticed there's no key. It's a push button.
Push button start.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Most trucks are, you know, obviously still keyed, and
right.
This one isn't. The other thing I noticed that's missing is a volume knob. That to me is hard. Why did you get rid of the volume knob?
You know, we're following the pilot in an application of our 8-inch DA screen, which still offers an incredible amount of technology and features for the customer. And at this time, we do have the option of using the volume button on the steering wheel instead of volume knob. So that's where we're at right now.
Hey, Roman, did you know that the new Honda Ridgeline has a payload of just over 1,500 pounds?
That's pretty good.
And it can tow up to 5,000 pounds.
Wait, what? Five what?
5,000 pounds.
5,000 pounds.
5,000 pounds.
You know that most pickups in this class can tow at least 6,500.
Yeah, but how many of them can hold a 4x8 sheet of drywall?
Really?
Really.
Did they increase the width of the bed?
They did. They increased the width of the bed.
And where are the cutouts for the wheel wells?
Ah, good question. It's Honda Engineering.
Does that have to do with torque vectoring?
It does not have to do with torque vectoring.
I'm just going to go ahead and open and close the door, maybe open up the tailgate.
What we noticed with our first generation Ridgeline, we had a VTM4 button. And even though that vehicle was an intelligent all-wheel drive system, many of the customers were confused by the button. They didn't know, was that the button that turned the four-wheel drive on or not? So they said, basically, we want something that's smarter than we are. So with the new system, we have our iVTM4 system. It's an intelligent all-wheel drive system that is in operation at all times. You don't have to turn it on. It detects when you need traction and what wheel needs the traction. It also has torque vectoring, so it can apply traction to the right or the left side independently. This terrain management button just gives you a little bit extra flexibility if you want to dial in traction for a specific mode. and this gives you the opportunity for snow, sand, and mud. So if you're going off-road in a sand dune park and you want to lower your tire pressures, you can use this mode. It won't then give you all the warnings for low tire pressure. It applies the optimum engine and transmission operation for that mode. So you don't ever have to use this, but this is just gives you the opportunity to kind of dial in the traction that you're looking for.
And the other thing that's untruck-like is there's no tall haul button, but there is this, is it D4? Is
that D4 button on the side.
Yeah, it's right over here. What does that do?
So that basically just holds D4 or fourth gear. It's a 6-speed AT that keeps you in fourth, keeps it from shifting up. So if you were looking for some engine braking on a long or slightly downhill condition, you could use the D4 to provide that.
And there's, of course, all the safety equipment that people have gotten used to in almost high-end cars now, right?
And no other truck, even talking about the top high-end full-size trucks, offer the amount of technology that we do from a safety standpoint. So yeah, we have both the camera that's mounted up here on the windshield, as well as a radar that's mounted behind the front grille. Those two systems work together to give you active cruise control, lane departure warning, front collision warning, CMBS, which is the collision mitigation braking system. So if a car senses a collision, it'll automatically brake for you. Lane keep assist, so it actually will steer the car back into the lane. So it's an amazing array of technology that we provide for the customer.
I gotta tell you, Jason, I think this is the sportiest, torquiest, and most fun in a lot of ways to drive car in its class.
What about truck?
See, that's the thing, right?
It's got to be more fun to drive than the Colorado and the Tacoma.
That's you hit my point. You know, people care about how much a truck tows, right? In essence, how big of a tool the thing can be used as, right? They care about how much it hauls. They don't necessarily immediately care about how it drives. But for all of you who care about how a truck drives, this drives really well.
Okay.
Really well. It's comfortable, it's quiet, it's the steering is actually, I wouldn't say precise, but it's communicative, which in most trucks is not the case.
Yeah.
What it isn't, of course, is brawny and beefy and mean and badass in the kind of traditional truck sense.
But also that's a traditional full-size truck. This is still the mid-size truck market. This is going against the Canyon and the Tacoma.
Yeah, but
not against the F-150 and some of the larger ones.
Right, but a TRD Pro Tacoma or a Pro 4X Frontier are pretty badass looking trucks,
okay.
Right? And there's no version of that. And I asked Honda and they said there's no version of that kind of ultimate off-road worthy truck coming in the Ridgeline.
So again, we have what we feel is the best comfort, the best versatility in an interior in the midsize segment. And one thing that gives us that advantage is our unibody construction. So if you'll see down here on the floor, there is no tunnel or hump in the middle, and it's completely flat, you know, outside of this plastic garnish. But this amount of space you see here is class leading. You can put in a mountain bike with its tire on. You can put in dog crates, big flat screen TV boxes, whatever you want to put back here, there's tons of space. Or you can fold the 60-40 seat back down and you can actually leave these objects in the car. So this will actually hold a full golf bag under the seat in this mode, which no other midsize truck has that opportunity. So it's out of sight, safe and secure.
If you're gonna take this car on a family vacation,
ching,
oh, I said it again. You're gonna get me on this.
You're gonna take this truck?
If you're gonna take this truck on a family vacation,
yes.
I'd much rather take this Honda truck than I would a TRD version with all the big Baja wheels on it.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, like what you said is absolutely correct. Honda has built probably the most luxurious, most comfortable, most family-friendly midsize
truck. Truck. Say it with me. Truck.
Whoa, I'm
saying
it,
Roman.
I'm saying it, but behind the wheel, I'm not feeling it, dude. In class.
But you're feeling the comfort.
I am.
How's the visibility?
Visibility is excellent. I mean, okay. Honda does just a wonderful job. By the way, I noticed there's a little...
Yes, it's called the conversation mirror.
Yeah.
We've been using it for a while.
What else is this mirror on?
What else is... Oh, on
yeah,
the
yeah, what
sunglass
other vehicle?
Holder?
Yeah, what other vehicle do okay. you see that? What,
it might be on the Odyssey and
yeah.
the Pilot, possibly,
yeah.
Maybe.
And where is this powertrain from? The Pilot?
It's from the Pilot.
Well, certainly a bed is what makes a truck a truck.
It looks very wide.
It is very wide. We, based on what our customers were asking for, as well as knowing that our own Honda motorcycle products had grown over the years, we gave the customers a little bit larger bed in every direction.
I see 8 tie-downs.
We have 8 tie-downs, each rated at 350 pounds.
And then here's a question for you. Now, this has become standard in the industry, right? Which is a dampened But this one doesn't have it. Why is that? Because of this?
Because no,
because of that?
No other truck has this.
The tailgate will...
All right. Tailgate opens like a door, in which case you don't need a damper.
All right. And then, of course, you've got... Why don't you show me the magic here?
Right. So the tailgate opening this way provides two different benefits. One is that you can reach objects that are just in the bed by itself.
And you've got a new little cubby hole here for right. gloves and such. And look at that. Yeah, cool.
400-watt AC inverter outlet there.
That's nice.
So you can power your TVs, your blenders at your tailgate. Charge up your batteries, but the secret, the magic in the Ridgeline is this in-bed trunk, something that no other truck can do. Based on our unibody construction,
80-gallon cooler.
82-quart, not gallon.
Oh, 82-quart. Okay.
Cooler. So one of the largest coolers. You can put that in here, or you can just fill this whole thing up with ice and drinks, and you don't even need the cooler. It's got a drain plug in the bottom if you want to use it for dirty storage or drain out water.
Nice.
And it is weatherproof.
And these are little hooks for grocery bags?
These are the little grocery bag nubs here. We have dividers down here, so you can actually, if you want to cut your own plywood dividers, or you can buy dividers. These little shelves here are for the tray that slides back, so it's easy access for the spare tire.
Now, I noticed the spare tire is a space saver. That's unusual in this segment. Most trucks have full-sized.
It's the same that we had on the original Ridgeline. It also came with a space saver tire.
All right, and can you tow with it, and can you go off-road if you have... with a flat, in either of those circumstances.
Certainly the tire is rated to handle the tongue load that we recommend. Right. So if you were towing and you needed to replace your tire and get to a safe place to get it fixed, you could do that. We do offer an extra mounting point. If you focus in on the headboard over here, in between those two bolts, there's a little plug. And if you pull that plug out, that's where you can actually bolt a second tire, whether it's full size, to the headboard. So if you were a hardcore off-roader, or you were concerned about
plug right there?
Yeah, okay. Or if you were concerned about towing very long distances, you could take another tire and mount it up there, and that way you would have a spare if you needed it.
For right now, it's certainly an interesting truck that Honda has built in this midsize segment. And you know what? My bottom line is they will sell this, because right now the midsize truck segment is on fire. They can't build enough Tacomas, they can't build enough Canyons, Colorados, and I think Honda's got a winner on its hands.
I agree 100%.
Well, of course you agree. Because it's got torque vectoring.
You said Honda and winner in the same sentence. I agree.
All right.
All of our all-wheel drive Ridgelines come with a trailer towing package completely standard. So that includes the trailer hitch with a 7-pin connector. It also comes with the radiator and the transmission cooler standard.
So basically you're saying it's set up for...
It's set up for towing right out of the box. You don't really need to add anything to it.
And what's your towing rating?
Tow rating is 5,000 pounds.
Okay, and how about your payload rating?
Payload is 1,584 pounds max,
okay,
which is class leading.
And tongue weight?
Tongue weight is 12%, so it'd be 600 pounds.
That's okay. All right, so I guess you could tow a small boat.
We have the 22-foot boat that you saw here, the bass boat, with the BF-250 engine on it, weighs right at 4,800 pounds.
And then maybe some stuff that would go with it, like fuel or...
Yeah, I mean, that one has 300 pounds of batteries in it for the trolley motors and such, so it's quite optioned.
As always, this is Roman and...
Honda Pro Jason.
Saying thanks for watching. Remember, check out TFL Car and TFL Truck, and I'm saying both on purpose, for more news, views, and of course, real-world truck reviews, and we will put this on truck.
That sounds good. And as always, I'm the Honda Pro, and now you're in the know.
Why don't you come to your website too, just completely.
I'm going to go for it, just find me on YouTube, Honda Pro Jason.
The Chevy Colorado started something really interesting. It made a mid-sized truck seem more like a crossover. Basically, when you're driving it and you don't look back, you can't tell you're in a truck. Now this is a proper trucky truck. When you get in it, you know you're in a truck. It drives and feels like a truck. The Honda Ridgeline, well, this has taken that Chevy concept to the next level. And what I mean by that is, can you imagine a front-wheel drive truck? Well, here it is. You can get this in either all-wheel drive or front-wheel drive. Those, of course, are only available in four-wheel drive or rear-wheel drive. Good.